Oasis Audio presents Anne Frank Remembered by Miep Gies and Alison Leslie Gold. Read for you by Barbara Rosenblat.
I'm Wayne Shepherd, and we're talking with author Alison Leslie Gold, whose collaborative book, Anne Frank Remembered, is now available as an audiobook from Oasis Audio. It's the story of Miep Gies, a woman who helped hide the Anne Frank family from the Nazis until an anonymous informant betrayed them. Alison, thanks for taking the time to talk with us today.
Glad to talk to you.
Before we speak about Anne Frank Remembered, you've written a number of books, many of them on the theme of World War II and the Holocaust, survival stories, really. What has led you as a writer to pursue this course?
Anne Frank Remembered, my connecting up to the Anne Frank story and to Miep kind of was what brought my foot in the door. And once I was involved in this subject matter, it just was a kind of natural progression. It's a very compelling subject matter, mm-hmm. and it just drew me in. And for 20 years of my life, I've written about that subject.
I was just curious if the topic found you or if it was the other way around.
Well, I think it found me. I mean, that's interesting that you put it that way, because most people don't. But I feel like fate really put it onto my horizon. Mm-hmm. I'd been working in Hollywood, doing other things, working in television. I had not had an interest, particular interest in the Holocaust, though I had read Anne's diary when I was in high school. But and I accidentally stumbled on the story, and it was kind of a moment of chills, because I just realized that it was a story that had needed to be told.
Mm-hmm. In this book and others, you have heard and chronicled the stories of Holocaust survivors, timeless stories. You mentioned you read the Diary of Anne Frank in high school. I think most people have at one time or another. But it seems like in these times that we're living in right now, we need to remember and understand these stories, don't we?
Unfortunately, I guess we do, because in a sad story like Anne Frank's story, I mean, the fact that her diary survived, although she didn't, is something that helps us all. You know, that she left us this gift, even though she didn't survive. And of course, I mean, the evil of the time and of the many. You know, the fact that it still exists, terrible circumstances all over the world still exist like that. I mean, it is as a lesson or a warning, or however you want to put it. It is important.
When did you write with Miep Gies? We'll talk about her in a moment, but when did the book first come out?
The book first came out in 1987. She was in her late 70s. Her husband was in his 80s. It was an immediate bestseller, translated into, I guess, about 19 languages. A movie was made out of it, a television movie, and various other, many, many things happened. And then recently, I mean, this book has been selling for 20 years plus, and as it happens, one of the ironies of the story is the fact that when I went to Miep and her husband, I told them they were old and they better hurry and tell me their let me write their story. And
how did they respond to that?
Well, it was part of what made them agree to do it. But ironically, even though he passed away quite a few years ago, she's still alive, and she's about to celebrate her 100th birthday. She's very much alive. And because so much has new and, you know, new kind of revelations have happened in the Anne Frank world, the Simon Schuster and Oasis are reissuing this book with a new epilogue.
Mm-hmm. And now it's an audiobook as well.
The audiobook,
right.
Yes. You know, which will include the new epilogue that really kind of brings up to date many of the things that have happened recently, and also celebrates Miep's 100th birthday and lets her tell us what it's like to be a 100-year-old who's outlived everyone.
And that's remarkable.
It really is. She's wonderful.
We're speaking about Miep Gies. That's the American pronunciation of her Dutch name. I know there's a Dutch twist to that. But
no, that's good enough.
Yeah, tell me about this woman and her husband and her family as you got connected with her and began to hear this story of how they harbored the Frank family and those associated with the Frank family.
Well, Miep is actually from Vienna, and she came from a very poor background. And after World War I, she was ill and starving. And as it happened, she was brought to the Netherlands by a group, a workers' group, with a lot of other hungry little children. She was 10 years old, and she was fed, and her life was saved. And most of these other little children went back to Vienna, but Miep loved Holland and ended up staying there and becoming almost more Dutch. In 1933, as it happened when Hitler came to power in Germany, Miep, who was a young girl, a young office worker, got a job with a German refugee named Otto Frank. He had a little factory that had a kind of kit for housewives that made jam. Hmm. And she was hired to be a kind of talk to housewives on the phone who screwed up the recipes. And Otto Frank had just come to Holland from Germany because Hitler had come to power in Germany, and because Otto Frank was Jewish, and his young family was too, he decided to get out of Germany, and he thought Holland would be a safe place because in the previous war, Holland had been a neutral country. So he brought his little business to Holland, and then his little family. Anne was four when she first came, and Miep started working for him. And as time passed, she became friendly with the family and knew Anne and Margot, the sister, as children, and she was just a family friend. And when she started being connected to Jan, who was a Dutch social worker, young man, and who she eventually married, he got to know the Franks, too. And then in 1940, to everyone's shock, when Nazi Germany attacked Holland, the Franks were trapped in Holland, and within a year or two, the Germans had occupied Holland and started to really put a noose around the necks of Jewish people and other people who didn't agree with his policies, and among them were the Franks. And at that point, it was almost impossible to get out of the country, so Mr. Frank made a plan to take his family and go and live in some storage rooms in back of his business. And he asked several friends who were Christians, who were connected to the business, to help the family while they were in hiding. And among them was his employee and friend, Miep. Hmm. And so in July of 1942, the Franks disappeared from Amsterdam into these four little rooms with another family, and for 25 months, Miep and several others, among them her husband, brought food and library books and warm conversation and friendship and good cheer and
putting themselves at risk in doing so.
Totally. It was at that point, it was a crime to help Jewish people who were considered outlaws. The fact that they had disappeared, had gone into hiding, because the reason they'd gone, the final thing that had made them go into hiding was that Margot had received an order to work in forced labor. So the fact that she had disobeyed that order made her an outlaw. Mm-hmm. So, yes, Miep and the others were really risking their lives. So for those 25 months, Miep and the others worked in the office, and every day, several times, when the factory workers weren't around, would go up into the hiding place. And meanwhile, Anne, who had received a little diary for her 13th birthday 2 weeks before she went into hiding, was busily working on this diary to pass the time. And Miep would bring scrap paper in because very quickly Anne filled up her diary. And it was something that that occupied Anne, and no one really imagined until later what a wonderful document but was being.
Did I read that Miep actually was the one who discovered Anne's diary?
Yes, Miep was, because what happened was after 25 months in hiding, and this meant that the people sat all day, could not move because the business was going on below, would sit quietly, and then when the business closed, they would go about their business inside. No one, they never went out once. And in 1944, although at that point the war, the Germans were losing the war, and it was really a matter of time before the war would end, they were somehow they were betrayed and arrested and sent to concentration camps, deported from Holland.
And this happened to the Gies family as well, Miep and Jan?
No. What happened was the Gestapo came and arrested the Jewish people who were in hiding. And when they went into the hiding place, they were looking for valuables, money and silver and jewelry. And Anne kept her diary and all her papers in her father's briefcase. And looking for the valuables, they just threw all the papers on the floor. And after the people were arrested and taken away, Miep and her husband and another office worker went up into the hiding place, which, of course, was a mess. And one of the things she saw was Anne's diary and all her papers. And so really, just out of the kindness of her heart, Miep gathered all the papers together. You know, not because she knew it was going to be a famous document, but because it was Anne's
something personal
pride and joy.
Yeah.
And she just collected it and put it in her desk drawer, hoping to return to Anne when she came back from wherever she had been sent.
Well, I know the full story is in the book, Alison, but what happened to Miep and Jan when it was discovered that they were assisting the Frank family?
What happened was the Gestapo came in the morning to the office, and the two men who ran the office, who were friends of Otto Frank's and in on the hiding, were in the office. Miep was in the office, and they immediately told Miep to leave when the Gestapo went into another room. And
we hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.